I'm Andrew Wasson from Creative Guitar Studio. Thanks for joining me for another one of my guitar lessons. This time around, we're going to do some guitar technique ideas, and we're going to be covering some different kinds of rhythmic variations, and we'll do some drill exercises to really get this whole area up to another level in your guitar playing. Now, this all came to us as a question from Shawn. He's out in Athens, Ohio. He wrote in saying, I'm having huge problems with getting different rhythms into my melody lines. I enjoy making up melodies, but they all end up really generic rhythmically. I like to get my melody ideas using more diverse rhythm types. What kinds of technical drills can I do to build more variety with eighth notes, triplets, 16th notes, and using syncopation? Thanks from Shawn in Athens, Ohio, USA. Well, hey, thanks for writing in, Shawn. You know, using guitar techniques, drills, and studies is probably one of the best ways to practice the different types of single note rhythms. Now, these kinds of technical drills are not only really good for building better picking ability, but they're good for also going and developing your left and right hand coordination to higher levels. So in this lesson, we'll take a run through practicing eighth note exercises, 16th note drills, we'll do some triplet ideas, and we'll eventually move on to some syncopated picking exercises as well. By the end of the lesson, you should have a really helpful group of picking studies that will get you going and integrating several new rhythmic patterns into your melody lines. Well, in getting started, I wanted to first organize a movable eighth note workout. And I think this type of study is going to help in developing your eighth note feel quite a lot. Even if you perhaps feel like your eighth note count isn't too bad, once you can get an exercise going that's slightly more complex, and we're going to talk about some specific kinds of studies that we're going to look at through every one of these examples in the lesson. It's going to be really important. But once you can, you know, get some studies going and really put them to work with a metronome and really develop your skill set, it's going to be a big difference in how you're feeling this count overall. And also, I think since this drill operates between three guitar strings, which is sort of the crucial element, that's the real unique thing about all these exercise examples that we're going to be going through in this lesson plan. They're all involving a group of three guitar strings in the layout of the study. And because of that, it's going to help with string crossing while we're alternate picking. And that's another emphasis I want to place on all these studies. They're all going to be alternate picked. Now, the main ideas with this first study in example one are going to be accuracy, a strong connection with the tracking ability, you know, good feel, good connection to the count on the metronome, and of course, really good work with the left and right hands at developing good rhythmic feel. Now, the first example is going to be up here in seventh position. This is the first layout that we're going to do. And the eighth note drill goes like this. So that's the study right there. One and two and three and four and. Then what we're going to do for the purpose of the video is we're just going to move to a few other positions. What I would suggest doing, though, when you're practicing this at home is maybe set up a time frame of maybe a minute or even 2 minutes, or if you really want to get a heavy workout, go 3 minutes. I don't know if I would suggest going much more than 3 minutes, though, but and then within the time frame that you establish anyway, I would really suggest going all over the guitar fingerboard. So what I'm going to do next, I'm going to take that study. I'm going to set up a count on the metronome here of 112 beats per minute. I'm going to play this in a few different locations around the neck. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. There you go. I think you get a pretty good idea of how this is all rigged up. Now let's move to example number two. Next thing here, we're going to move into the world of some eighth note triplets. Now there's a serious feel change when moving into this rhythmic duration, so be very clear as to what the meter is prior to jumping into the routine. Remember, it's a group of three over one with the triplet feel. The exercise pattern I've established here operates between three strings again and begins with a double string cross, so go slowly and be sure to track your picking movements without rushing into this too fast. Now again, triplet meter, you know, we're feeling three attacks over one, so it's going to go one and two and three and four and it's going to be our feel for it. So one and two and three and four and and then we're going to move them around to a few other positions. But as I stated earlier, you know, you'll want to take this across the whole neck in some kind of time frame that you establish for yourself. Just play it all over the neck. Don't be concerned what, you know, what it sounds like. If you get between some different string sets and it kind of sounds a little bit off key or out of key, and you know what, don't worry about that. These are, you know, guitar technique exercises. So they're all about, you know, technical proficiency and not so much anything in the direction much of melody there. So I'm going to set the melody, the metronome, pardon me, up to, let's say, maybe about 92 beats per minute. And the feel on that is going to be 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4. And I'll play this down through a few positions here and just get it going across the neck. So here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Well, the next exercises will focus upon using 16th notes. In example 3, we'll break down another 3-string study that maintains a tight pattern around the string group. The pattern loops within the central region of the study and allows for the picking hand to develop a good alternate picking pattern throughout the 4 beats of the measure. Just work through the cycle of tones used in the exercise until the pattern is well memorized, then begin working on developing speed with the idea. How this idea works overall is we're going to start with the layout of it out here in the 7th position off 6th string. And remember, it's 16th notes, so the idea is going to be 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a. And you can hear that sort of internal loop of the pattern there. So you can see on the 3rd beat, we're just doubling up on it. Then, of course, you know, set your time frame, go across the neck, play it in other positions. So we'll get a metronome on, and I'll just play this in time. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, let's move on to example number 4. Moving into the triplet world is going to be next here with some 16th note triplets. They're going to create some very quick rhythmic meters, so it's important to take your time developing the technical ability to perform these faster studies. The triplet exercise in example 4 moves across 3 guitar strings, and just as our previous studies had done. However, since the speed of the 16th note triplet is kind of quick, more preliminary study is going to have to be done before attempting to increase the overall speed of the exercise. You know, once they're committed to memory, though, you can begin building your speed. I'd probably say for a metronome pulse, you know, keep it down in the 50s. Just, you know, make sure you have a really nice, stable metronome count that you can work to that's manageable. Now, how this exercise is going to go is we're going to start on the 6th string, 7th fret, and we're going to carry over across 3 strings, going right across there, having 7th, 9th, and then 7th. Between the 6th, the 5th, and the 4th. Then we're going to double up there. Then we're going to carry on another group of 3 strings. And then how the feel of this works, of course, because it's 16th note triplets, we're going to be going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then, of course, you can move it around the neck. Okay, so here's the metronome count. So we're in 2-4 time, and we're doing 2 of these per measure. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that, okay? Here we go. So 1, 2. So they're pretty quick. Take your time with them. You know, maybe that might be too fast for you in the beginning. You might have to roll the metronome way down into the 40s or something. But just take your time with these studies. They are getting faster. Make sure they're manageable and you know how everything's operating before getting that metronome going. And once you have some skill with them, fire up that metronome and go all across the neck, set up your time frame, get some good work out of it. Well, the next exercises I have all operate using a syncopated feel. Now, it's a pretty straightforward, basic kind of syncopated feel, but it is still syncopated nonetheless. With this rhythmic feel, the pulse is slightly off the expected downbeat. In the study, for example, 5, the feel loses the beats of 2 and 4. So remember, if these rhythmic feels are really brand new for you, try maybe clapping and counting them for the first few times that you run through the example. This is going to help you get a much better idea for the overall meter of the rhythmic variation exercise. But if we just take a look at the first study here, measure of the example 5 study, we've got a 8th note going to a quarter note, so it's 1 and 2 and... That's the upbeat of 2. So 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. So that's the count of it. Like I said before, you may want to clap that through or just kind of like strike at your strings. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. You know, anything just to get the feel into your mind, and then you can begin working on finger placement and all the technique elements. Then you can turn on a metronome eventually and start playing it in time. But once more, here's the study. It goes like this. So that's the feel of it overall. I'm going to pop the metronome on here. I think I have it set at 72 beats per minute. And here's how the study goes. 1, 2, 3, and 4, and 1, and 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, and 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, and 2, and 3, and 4, and 1. Start to count and play at the same time like that. But you can tell it's really off beat, and it has a really interesting feel to it because we're losing the beats of 2 and 4. Now I'm going to keep my mouth shut. Now I'm just going to play along with the metronome. Here's how it goes one more time. So 2, 3, 4. I think you get a really good idea of it now. It's a lot easier to play without talking either. So anyway, there's example number 5. It's really an interesting study. It's more or less, as you can tell, a 2-bar phrase, but it's going to be great for you to start getting exposed to that syncopated count. Now let's move on to example 6. In the example 6 studies, we're going to be getting into the world of triplets, and we're going to run through a study that applies one of the most popular triplet ideas out there. It's mixing the standard triplet feel with a shuffle feel. Now that means we're going to have a quarter note and an eighth note underneath the triplet symbol. And in example 6, the triplet figure occurs on the first measure's first beat in its basic form. And then, that's going to happen also on the beat of 3 as well. But on the beats of 2 and 4, we're going to have that shuffle feel occur in this study. The feel creates a slight delay off the downbeat and initiates what could almost be referred to as, I guess, a skipping feel within the meter. As always, commit the fingering patterns to memory first and know what the feel's like, then begin developing a good sense of ideas for the meter and how the rhythm operates. You can start increasing your speed as time goes on by using a metronome. I'm going to dial it up a little bit here and have the metronome at around 92. And maybe before I fire that metronome up, I'm just going to play the thing down for you, give an idea what this thing sounds like. So we're going to have our standard triplet coming out off of that 7th fret of the 6th string. And it's going to go in a chromatic fashion first. It's going to go like this, 1 and like that, right in a row, 7, 8, 9. Then we're going to have that shuffle feel. So we're going to go... Then we're going to have another triplet on 3rd beat, kind of come backwards there, going... So you can hear on the 3rd beat, there's our triplet, standard triplet. And then we have on the 4th beat, the shuffle. So that's that delay. So you can tell there it's like 1 and up. So altogether, the first measure of example 6 sounds like this here. Okay. And then of course, you can move that around, and I'll move it around a bit across the neck here once I fire up the metronome. Okay, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. You can tell it's a really interesting feel to match up that syncopated feel of the shuffle against the straight time feel. Can imagine what that could do, for your songwriting, for your improvising. It's going to really add some very different directions. But we're not done yet. I'm going to move next into the world of syncopated 16th note concepts. Well, you know, practicing technique exercises with the off-time feel involving 16th notes is an excellent way to develop not only better timing overall, but, you know, this feel of syncopation is going to bring in an excellent rhythmic flow to your guitar playing that may not really be there right now. You know, I can clearly recall hearing, many years ago when I was transcribing a lot of solos, how different lead players that I was transcribing would kind of play more syncopated, more around the beat during their improvisations. And I was into guys like Carlos Santana, first really big time, and then Larry Carlton, and that was, I first found him with Steely Dan, and then I got into his solo stuff, and then I got into George Benson, and these are just sort of a few people. Also liked Eric Johnson a lot, but you know, they didn't really play in the beat and on the beat all the time. They had a lot of syncopated ideas going on, and it really helped me grow as a guitar player to listen to those guys and try to, you know, do what they were doing. Now, in example 7, this is a really good starter exercise of syncopation with 16th notes that can apply a delay here off of an 8th note. It's in 3/4 time. It's going to have a little bit different feel. So just remember, the count is moving 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, just like that. And the feel is going to go, the exercise rather, is going to go like this. So that's over the count of three. So 1, 2, 3. Here it is again. 1, 2, 3. So count that out. Realize what it's supposed to sound like. And then when you're ready and you got it all mapped out, turn the metronome on and give it a try around the neck. 1, 2, 3. Really interesting feel. Now let's move on to my final example exercise, or example 8, pardon me. I'm going to be organizing a rhythmic variation exercise here that applies a couple of ties within the measure that are going to act to produce a loss of the downbeats of both 2 and 4. This is an offbeat feel, and it's going to really apply another figure that we saw back from example 7. It's the 16th into an 8th and then into another 16th. That's going to occur on the beat of 3. So obviously this example is going to be a little more challenging exercise than what we've done so far, but whatever you think of it, just realize that any rhythm idea can be developed. As long as we work slowly and we fully understand the count and the beat structure, the real trick is going to be committing the idea to memory. So work slowly, always build your speed with a metronome, and keep track of your progress. So here's how example 8 moves along. We're going to start on the 8th fret of the 6th string, and we're going to have a 16th note blast right out of the gate there on the beat of 1. And you can hear that syncopated part off the beat of 3. I'll play a little bit slower for you. So right around, you know, the midpoint of the measure there, we have that syncopation occurring, and the front and the back of the phrase is really just nothing but 16th notes there. Now I'm going to turn on the metronome and move this around the neck a little bit and give you a chance to hear how it really sounds in time. 1, 2, 3, 4. You know, practicing different kinds of modifications to rhythmic durations within guitar technique drills is an excellent way to highly develop both rhythm concepts, and along with that, it'll develop your picking technique and your coordination skills. See, the patterns we can create for learning different kinds of rhythmic meter also work well for developing our left and right hand tracking, and these studies can be extremely helpful when we rehearse them between a group of 3 guitar strings. As you saw within each of the example drills I just went through in the lesson. So work on the studies I've created for this lesson plan, and also go forward in creating your own. The benefits are definitely well worth all the effort. Anyway, that's all for now. Once again, thanks for watching. Have yourself a great week working on all this stuff. You can download a handout and an MP3 jam track for this video over at my website at andrewwasson.com, and you can follow me on Twitter, like me on Facebook, and subscribe to my other guitar blog, YouTube channel. You'll find that online at Guitar Blog Update. The links are all for you in the description box of this video. Take care, everyone, and I'll see you next time. Bye for now.